Welcome everyone. I'm Shashi Kandargar. I'm taking a lecture on EC5E151. Today we are going to discuss basics of electrical circuit element. Circuit elements are the components which are used in the electrical circuit. The electrical circuit may have the components active component or passive components. They are also defined as a unilateral or bilateral component. So electrical circuit elements connected in any random manner in a closed path is called as an electrical circuit. The electrical circuit elements are, for example, resistance, capacitance, and inductor, whose value is given in L, C. The property of the electrical component to provide the obstacle in the path of flow of current is called as resistance. And the similar property of these two components is called as reactance. That is denoted by XC in case of a capacitor, capacity is reactance. In case of an inductor, it is named as inductive. Component, but a DC means the amplitude of supply is not changing at any instant of time. It is constant for any instant of time. For example, the supply maintaining certain amplitude V. This type of supply is called as direct current or DC supply. And if the amplitude is varying in accordance to time, in any periodic nature or any non-periodic, is called the alternating current. Generally, this wave, they follow a wave shape, either sinusoidal or square wave or trapezoidal wave. For example, sine wave, the amplitude is changing in accordance to time in a periodic manner at any instant of time, is called as alternating current. If it is changing its amplitude, a one cycle period is this much, and it is having a frequency which is repetitive in nature, can be given as frequency is equal to 1 upon 10. The capacitive reactance of these two components, which are called the reactive components, is represented by, it is related to frequency. For example, XC is 1 upon 2 pi FC, where F is the frequency. So the capacitive reactance is depending on the frequency, and an inductive reactance is given by 2 pi FL. Again, it is depending on frequency. The value of resistance is not depending on the frequency of supply. Hence, when we talk about a capacitance using alternating current, if the frequency is not zero, which is in case of DC it is zero, then F is equal to zero, XC will be infinite, or we can say this will act as an open circuit when the XC tends to infinite. it will act as a open circuit, and if it is applied to inductance, DC supply frequency is 0, then it will act as a XL equal to 0 ohm. That means it will act as a short circuit. So the value of these components, means the property of this component is not known. They will either be short circuited or open circuited when applied to series parallel combination in a DC circuit. So generally in a DC circuit, the components, the DC circuit analysis is the methodology by which we know the value of current, the electrical parameters, current or voltage, or the potential difference, or the power dissipation in the component. So let's start with the DC circuit analysis in our course plan. You all might have heard about the Ohm's law. We state that the voltage applied in a circuit is proportional with the current flowing in the circuit, and that proportionally constant, proportionality constant, is called as resistance. This is the proportionality constant. We'll discuss about Kirchhoff's laws. There are two laws of Kirchhoff given in circuit. Before that, let me introduce in a circuit what are the terminology. Let's say there are certain electrical components, resistance, inductance, capacitance, or supply voltage, or supply current, or any other electrical component. They are suppose connected in a closed path circuit like this. This, for example, a voltage source V, also sometimes represented by a circle with sign. These are the symbols of the electrical circuit. Suppose the value of resistance is R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, and this is some battery voltage. In this circuit, there are few terms that these all components are known as electrical circuit elements. R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, battery, these are all electrical elements. And they are joined by means of some conducting wire or connecting circuit. These are connecting parts. When two electrical elements are joined together, they form a node. Joining point of the battery and the resistance is here, it is one node. A joining point of a resistance and R3 is here, which is also with R2, it is also a node. These two points joining together is forming a node, node 3. Similarly, R5 and R2 joining together is a node, N4. And the resistance and the battery negative terminal is joined together here is a node. So we can see there are total 5 nodes in this circuit. And the nodes at which, so what is the definition of node is, node are the points where two circuit elements are joined together. More than one element is joined together, right? The nodes at which the current is distributed or contributed, such nodes are known as junction. So there is one term node, there is one term junction. So junction in the circuit are the nodes at which circuit current is either distributed or contributed. Right? So we can see that if there is a current here because of node 1 entering into R1, this current is not going to change. These two are going to be same. So this is not a junction. It is not a junction. But at this point, if current is entering here or leaving, whatever, assume that it is entering, and suppose it is entering here and leaving here. In these three currents, the sum or because the current is going to be either distributed or contributed. So this is essentially a junction. It is one junction. If this entry is not a node, not a junction, and for node 4, again the current is, if it is there in the each branch, it is going to be contributed or either distributed. So sure, it is going to be a junction, and this is not a junction. Now you can notice here N2 and N4, these are two specific nodes which are where the current is either distributed or contributed, hence they are known as junction. So nodes at which current is either distributed or contributed is known as a junction of the circuit. The another term is known as mesh or loop. Loop is a closed path or circuit element. From this example we can see the circuit which is drawn here that there are so many loops, like there is a closed path of circuit elements here. There is a closed path of circuit element here. In fact, this is also a closed path of circuit element. So there are three loops. So closed path of electrical circuit element or circuit element is called as loop of the circuit. There is a bit of very minor difference. There is another term which is also related to loop. Mesh. Mesh are the loops in the circuit which does not contain any loop inside. For example, if you say this loop is there, this loop is there, they can also be called as mesh. But if you talk about this mesh, it is having one branch which is actually common between two loops. So this cannot be called as a mesh. So there are two mesh in this example. There are three loops in this circuit. There are two junctions in the circuit. And there are total 5 nodes in the circuit. These are the basic terms related to the circuit. Out of this component, there is one more term which we generally use, that is unilateral or bilateral component. Electrical elements which are either connected in any direction in the circuit, if they do not change their property, if used one time in one direction and then change its terminal, then such elements are called as bilateral elements. For example, a resistance, suppose this is terminal 1, this is terminal 2, and in the latter case we have connected 1 here and 2 here, they are not going to change. The property of resistance is going to remain the same. It is going to behave the same resistance value. Hence, a resistance is a bilateral element. Y means 2, lateral means direction. So it can work similarly in the two directions. If you talk about a battery, if battery terminal is plus minus, it is allowing a current to flow like this. But if this battery direction, because it is having polarity, if direction is changed, the amount of current is also going to be changed. So battery is a unilateral element, unilateral electrical element. Capacitor, if it is a polarized capacitor, is a unilateral, and in case it is a unpolarized capacitor, it is a bilateral element. Inductor is a bilateral element, like this. After knowing this basic terminology of electrical circuit element, let me talk about the electrical circuit analysis, and then the one basic method is there that is given by Kirchhoff's laws. The one rule of Kirchhoff law is known as Kirchhoff voltage law. And the other rule is Kirchhoff's current law. Let me start our discussion first about Kirchhoff's voltage law. Kirchhoff's voltage law is actually applicable in mesh and loop. And it seems that the algebraic sum of the voltage and voltage drop in a loop or mesh is zero. Circuit elements, loop or mesh, always is zero. Let's understand this Kirchhoff law from a very basic example. To understand this, let me draw a circuit. For example, there is a loop of some batteries or voltages connected. It is a closed path of battery is there. We are taking one part out of these two voltage or voltage drop. Voltage drop is going to be across resistance, and voltage is the EMF across the battery. So let's take first part of this that it says, and if suppose I have a closed loop. And there are few battery voltages denoted by these battery connected like this, V1, V2, V3 and V4. The algebraic sum of the voltage of this loop, or let's say in this case we can call mesh or loop, anything, is going to be zero. To write the equation, just consider that what is your direction of analysis. For example, I am going to write the equation in this direction from A, B, C, D, A. A better way to write this is, for example, you are passing through this path, and while passing through this element, you find an element V1. When you pass through this, you will first face a quality which we generally name as entering quality, and by leaving you will get another quality which is called as a leaving quality. Similarly, in this case, for example, you are passing from A to B, you will face first plus, which is entering quality, and leaving quality is minus. When you pass from this, you will face plus first and minus later. If you pass through this, you will face minus first and then plus later. And if you pass through this, you will face minus first and plus later. So, to write the KVL of this loop, what you can do is, what is the magnitude of the battery? Just before that, place either leaving quality or entering quality. That means for the complete loop it should be same. For example, if I write V1 and taking the entering quality, then I need to take V2 which is also with the entering quality, V3 with entering quality which is in this case is minus, and then entering quality by passing through this is minus V4. It is equally equal to, that's it. That is called as the Kirchhoff voltage law equation of this particular circuit comprised of only voltage elements. The another thing is if you take the leading quality also, if you take leading quality from any of the element in the direction of analysis is suppose A, B, C, D, A, then take the leading, then it means it should be for everything, it should be leading quality. Minus, minus, plus, plus, or minus, plus, minus, minus. A circuit may not be, a loop may not be having only the resistance component. Let's take second part, voltage drop. And let's see, for example, a circuit part is a made of battery and few resistance also. Let's say the resistance is value R1, this resistance value is R2. The Kirchhoff voltage loss in a circuit like this, where there is a voltage element, voltage source, and there is a component which will drop the voltage, which is drop element, R1, R2. The algebraic sum of this all will be equal to 0. For such case, obviously, because the drop will be IR, if the current flow is I, so we need to assume one current. And you can assume the current based on your own assumption. Only the value which will come, that is in the direction of mu, which you have assumed. So let's say, for example, direction is, I assume that the current is flowing in this direction and then it is named as I. If I current is flowing in this loop, which is in the direction A, B, C, D, A, and if I am going to analyze the equation also in the same direction, let's name it a direction of analysis DOA. Is A, B, C, D, A, and direction of current is also same A, B, C, D, A. This is direction which I have assumed the current. If both are considered or assumed in the same direction, or it is taken in the same direction, that I am writing the equation also in this direction, and if the direction of current is also assumed in the same direction, both are in one direction. For the resistance, for the drop element, write drop in potential, which is from plus to minus, fall in potential. And if you have assumed the direction of current is opposite, for example like this, direction of analysis is like this, A, B, C, D, A, and the direction of current assumed is opposite to this, across the resistance element or the drop element, mark if it is the direction of analysis, this is direction of current. Right. Rise in potential, it means mark first minus and plus, it is rise in the voltage. So let's write this. So for writing KVL, we need to write first polarity convention against the resistance. Suppose I have this loop which is consisting of voltage element and resistance also. So we need to write the polarity, because if you assume the current direction in the direction of analysis, same, the direction of analysis is like this, A, B, C, D, A, and direction of current assumed is also same, then just across the resistance, right? Fall in potential, it means plus first and minus later. Plus, minus. When you are passing through this, plus first, minus later. And battery, no doubt, it has one indication that this plus is minus, this plus is minus. We need not mention only across the resistance, drop element only will be marked the polarity. And now, for writing KVL, with similar case, but we have discussed, when we are passing through this, we can write plus of V1, if I am taking entering polarity, plus of what is the voltage drop here. I is flowing current, R is the resistance value, and entry current is plus. So we can write I R 1. While passing through this, the current flowing is I, entry current is plus, I R 2, plus of, sorry, plus. While passing through this, we are passing in the loop. So when passing through this, first this coming is minus, and then everywhere is entering quality, so here also it will be minus of V4 equal to. This is pitch of voltage. The second law of Kirchhoff is also known as Kirchhoff's current law. And Kirchhoff's current law says that when it is applicable to, because you know that KVL is applicable to the voltage and voltage drop in a mesh, and Kirchhoff's current law is applicable in node or junction. At any node or junction, for example, this is one node. Obviously, node is the point where current is will be either not will not be either distributed or contributed. So it will be junction. So let's say there is one junction in the circuit where there are so many branches, so many circuit elements are connected, and each branch current is different. For example, I1 here, I2 here, I3 is here, I4 is here in this direction, and I5 is in this direction, I6 is supposedly coming in this direction. So, the KCL says that algebraic sum at this junction will be 0. And the algebraic sum means the current either coming or going. We can also say that the current which are coming to the junction is equal to the current which are going away from the junction. For example, if we talk about I1, it is coming to the junction. I2 is coming to the junction. I3 is going away from the junction. I4 is going away from the junction. I5 is going away from the junction. And I6 is coming to the junction. So all coming current is equal to the outgoing current. We can also write it as, for this case, I1 plus I2 plus I6, this is coming, is equal to I3 plus I4 plus I5. Incoming current is equal to the outgoing current from the junction. With the current which are coming to the junction and current which are going away from the junction, is going to be same. This is switch of voltage law. So now we will discuss about one method which is derived based on the switch of voltage law. But before that, let me discuss few more methods for circuit analysis. DC circuit analysis methods are actually divided into two types of methods. One is called as direct method, another one is indirect method. Direct methods of circuit analysis are the process if we use in a circuit for circuit analysis, and if the current, if the circuit is in its original form, then it is called as a direct method. It is not reduced or converted into some other form. Similarly, in a circuit, if the original circuit is converted into some other form to know the value of electrical parameter, is called as an indirect method. We are initially starting with the direct methods, and then we will discuss few theorems, for example Fermi's theorem, Norton's theorem, which are indirect matter. Later we will discuss about this. So second analysis. In the direct method, there is one method which is called as mesh analysis, also known as Maxwell's loop current method. Or node analysis, the second another method is nodal analysis, or node voltage method, we have. Okay, to understand this, before that one more problem is, which method is, which we will use in between to solve the problem using Schatz theorems, all as source transformation. Voltage division rule, also known as voltage divider or potential divider rule, current division or current divider rule. Let's talk about this 3, 4, 5 first, then we'll go to Maxwell's loop current matter, mesh analysis. Source transformation. If you find in a circuit that there is a voltage and current source in having a parallel resistance across terminal A and B of voltage and the current source, suppose the value is I and the resistance connected is R. The source transformation says that it can be converted into a voltage source and a resistance in series between terminal A and B, where the value of voltage source will be V is equal to IR. With this quality, if the current is going down, the quality here will be plus minus. If the current source connects opposite, obviously it will be plus minus. And the resistance is in series. So what we could understand that source transformation says that current source in parallel resistance combination can be converted into a current voltage source with series resistance. Similarly, it is vice versa, that voltage source in resistance with series can be converted into a current source in parallel resistance. As this combination, it is not valid that you have a current source in series resistance cannot be converted into a voltage source with parallel resistance, cannot be converted. So this is sure that make sure that you have voltage source in series resistance can be converted into a current source with parallel combination. Current with parallel, voltage with series. So sometimes when we will do later this nodal analysis or mesh analysis, you find that in the circuit combination, if some portion is having individual separate part, current source connected with parallel resistance can be converted into a voltage source with series. This was source transformation. Voltage divider rule. You all know that there are two methods by which electrical components may be connected and they have their electrical value. For example, if I have a resistance connected with another resistance in a manner that one end of the terminal is connected with the first end of the other terminal. This combination is called as series combination. For example, this is connected, the series combination is connected of R1 and R2. And what is parallel combination? If one end of the one element is connected with the one end of the other element, and second end is connected with the second end, exactly, this combination is known as parallel combination. Okay, for example, for line B. In case of series, the resistance equivalent value will be R equivalent is R1 plus R2. This is the total value if the resistances are connected in series. And in case of parallel, of R1 and R2 resistance connected in parallel will be the equivalent resistance is 1 upon R is 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. Can also be said as if you take LCM of this, it is R1 plus R2. It means R is inverse of this, which is R1 plus R2. If there are three resistances, it is going to be R1 R2 R3. R1 upon R1 plus R2 plus R3 is equal to 1 upon R. If you simplify, that will be R is R1 R2 R3 upon R1 R2 plus R2 R3 plus R3 R3. So, in a series or parallel combination, we know that if the voltage applied across this and the current from the battery is I, the same current is going to flow through R1 and same current is going to flow through R2. So, current in series combination remains same. But what about voltage? The voltage drop in this case R1 will be I into R1, which is let's say V1, and drop here will be I into R2, which will be V2. So the voltage is different. V1 is not equal to V2. It is going to depend on if in case R1 R2 are same, then we can say voltage drop is same. Otherwise, it is depending on the value of R1 R2. So if two different resistances are connected in series, the voltage across these two resistances will be different. Voltage is not same. Voltage divider rule defines the same thing, same property. That in series combination, it is only applicable in series. And opposite to this, in current division, the current in case of parallel combination in this R1 R2 is going to be different, unlike series combination, but the voltage at R1 and R2 is same. So in parallel, voltage across any element is same and current is different. And in series, the voltage is different, this is for series, voltage is different depending on the value of R1 R2, and the current is same in the series circuit. So as the voltage is different, voltage divider rule defines that how the voltage in the individual element is distributed from the main voltage factor, main voltage source. Just for understanding, let's take this circuit of two resistances in series. The drop here is V1, drop here is V2. How we can say for a series combination? We know that V1 is equal to I into R1 and V2 is equal to I into R2. the total B is equal to I into R equivalent. The B is main voltage, equivalent of R1 R2 is R1 plus R2. This is correct. How this I can be defined as, because I is same, I can also say I is equal to V1 upon R1. Can I write? Or I can also say that I is equal to V2 upon R2, R1 plus R2 in the same equation. V is equal to I R equivalent. This is R equivalent of series R1 R2, R1 R2, R1 plus R2. And I is replaced by V1 by R1, and also in series combination I is there. We can also say it is V2 upon R2. From this we can find an important relation here, that V1, if we sum it out, V1 can be given as V1 into R1 upon R1 plus R2. Correct? V1 is V into R1 upon R1 plus R2. This is an important relation called as voltage divider rule. See, it is defining that how V1, which is the voltage of an individual component R1, is derived from V. It shows that V1 is equal to V into R1 upon R1 plus R2. And similarly, from this we can also relate V2. V2 is V into R2 upon R1 plus R2. If there are more than three resistors, for example R1, R2, R3, all the 4, 5 values can be known. The equivalent will be of 3 resistances R1 plus R2 plus R3. So we will write here R1 plus R2 plus R3, and it will be multiplying here with the remaining 2 resistances. If I say, if I want to know this value, V1, V1 is going to be V into R2 upon, sorry, V into R1 upon R1 plus R2. Similarly, if I want to know this V2, it can be given as V into R2 upon R2 plus R2. If there are 3 resistance, for example, one more resistance is there, R3, what is this value? Because combination of these 3 will be R1 plus R2 plus R3. So V into R1 upon R1 plus R2 plus R3. If this value we want to know, V into R2 upon R1 plus R2 plus R3. And V3 is the voltage across parallel resistances, V into R3 upon R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is known as voltage divider rule. Let's understand this from the example. Say there is a resistance of 8 ohm, 10 ohm, 5 ohm connected to a battery of 5 volt. From this 5 volt, because the total voltage is V, the voltage across is V1, V2, V3 is equal to V, then how it is divided? That's why it is named as voltage divider rule. It is only derived from series combination. 5 into 10 upon 10 plus 5 plus 8 is the voltage here. V at 10 ohm is 50 upon 23. Voltage at this is 5 ohm is 5 into V into 5 ohm, V into R3 resistance. So it is 25 upon 23. And the voltage here drop is 5 into 8, 40 upon 23. If you sum this all, 40 upon 23 plus 50 upon 23 plus 25 upon 23. This is 23, 40 plus 50 plus 25. Tugal Sami is again saying 5 to 15 minutes. Let's talk about now the current divided rule. Unlike the voltage division, which is only applicable to a series combination, current division rule, because in parallel we know that voltage remains same in the individual component and the current is different, the current divider says, it shows that how the main current from the source is voltage battery, if the current coming out is I, how this I is divided in two branches I dimension, that is defined from current divider. To understand this, let's write this. We know that V is the voltage applied here. It is going to be equal to V1 in case of a parallel combination, is equal to V2. In parallel, voltage remains same. So V is equal to V1 is equal to V. V1 can also be given as I1R1. V2 can be given as I2R2, which are equal. This is also equal to V, which is if the battery is V, current coming out is I, then what is the current is? From the battery end, if the current is coming out, I into R equivalent is the total voltage. Right? I into R equivalent of a parallel combination. So, R equivalent of parallel is, if two components are there, R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. Is R equivalent. So V can be given equal to I into R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. We know that V is equal to V1, so I can also equate this equal to V1, here we have it. So V1, which is given as I1 R1, we can derive from this that I1 is equal to, you can say R1 will cancel out, I into R2 upon R1 plus R2. And I2, similarly, because we know V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V, this was V equal to this, I can also equate it equal to V2, V2 is I2 R2, so we can write I2 R2 into this, I into R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2, R2 will cancel out, the value is I into R1 upon R1 plus R2. So here it defines that what is I1? I1 is a branch current going in R1. This relation relates the main current I is coming out of the battery for supply. How this I1 is divided from that? It shows that it is I into the another resistance. If you are searching it in the first branch, it means R1 branch, multiply I with another branch, I into R2 upon R1 plus R2. It is very important part, this will be used in the further numerical analysis, network analysis, which we will do in the theorems. What if there is a 3 resistance, not 2 resistance, how current division can be done? For example, we have R1, R2, R2. The 3 resistance is connected with the battery voltage D, it supplies I. Current, we know that V is equal to V1 of this voltage, V2 is the voltage of this, and V3 is the voltage drop here. And the current flowing is suppose I1, I2, I3. The main voltage V can be said as I into R equivalent, which is V, can be written as I into R1, R2, R3 upon is a combination of 3 resistance in parallel, R1, R2, R3, we have seen. R1R2R3 upon R1R2 plus R2R3 plus R3R. So if I equate, because it's a parallel combination, V is equal to V1. If I write this as V1, and V1 is I1 into R1. If I write it as V1 replaced by I1 R1, R1 will cancel out. What you can see, I1 is equal to I into R2 R3 upon R1 R2 plus R2 R3 plus R3. Similarly, I2 can be given as I into remaining 2. If I2 there for C, R2 will not be there. It will be R1 R3 upon R1 R2 plus R2 R3 plus R3. And I3 can be given as I into 3 is there, so it will be R1 R2 here upon R1 R2. So we have also discussed voltage division, current division, and source transformation. These are called as methods. These are not theorems. These are the methods derived from the basic rule, Kirchhoff's voltage law, either Kirchhoff's current law, or the series parallel combination of SFP. Getting into detail of this, let me now discuss about mesh analysis. Mesh analysis is a method of circuit analysis which is derived from KVL. We already have seen before how to write KVL. And it is applicable in mesh. A simple rule is there for mesh analysis. Let's, for example, let's take one circuit of few components. Let's say R1, R2, R3, R4. How many meshes you can see in this circuit? 2. This is one mesh. Let me name it as M1, M2. So what is the procedure for writing, solving a problem using mesh analysis? First, find out how many meshes are there in the circuit. There are 2 mesh. Name them accordingly. Mesh is named unwise to the other mesh. So this is mesh 1, mesh 2. And now assign 2 currents in this mesh, which are not independent, but you are assigning a current of the mesh. This, for example, a current flowing in mesh 1 is I1. Direction may be of your own assumption. For example, I take it clockwise, you can also take it as anticlockwise. And a current flowing in mesh 2 is suppose I2. Doesn't mean that these are the independent currents on all the mesh. We will analyze it later. You can notice that this time I may take a current opposite to this. That is also possible. Current, I have taken both the current, assigned the current in my own choice. It is in the clockwise. Just for understanding, let's all assume that the current we are assuming is clockwise. For writing KVL, for example, if this loop is not there, how you will write KVL of this loop? You will write the polarities first of this mesh. Consider that this is not there, so how you will write polarity? If its direction of current is assumed like this, direction of analysis is supposed ABCDA in match 1. If this is not there, you will write it as dropping potential, because it is falling potential, because it is direction of analysis and current are same, ABCDA, ABCDA. If I assume it opposite, then we will mark it like similar to that as per the convention we assume. So it is falling potential plus minus, falling potential plus minus, falling potential plus minus, for battery we don't write falling. So what you need to do in mesh analysis is first identify how many meshes are there in the circuit, and after knowing this, after assuming the mesh number, assume some current as per your assumption. You can assume anything, whatever. So once you have assumed two currents, two meshes are already there, we can assume it is there, and the currents are either I2, write the polarity with the individual mesh. I have marked it inside just to understand that it will not have a confusion. Similarly, for mesh 2, consider that this mesh is not there, and if you need to write a KVL in this group, how you will write? You will mark the polarities here. Here. Now, write individual mesh equation, KVL equation. So what we have done till now in the mesh loop here, first identify meshes, then write polarity convention of assume current, and then polarity convention for writing KVL. And now write the KVL equation. KVL equation of this, what we can write is, if the current is I1 going here, in this part is I1 only, in this part. You need to assume that when you are writing an equation from mesh 1, while in the common branch it is flowing, it is not the only I1 flowing. One current is I1 going here and another current is I2. So when you write an equation for mesh 1, write this component as R1 is the value of resistance multiplied with I1 minus I. Similarly, if you will write, when you will write the equation for mesh 2, write it as I2 minus I1 into R1 with these polarity convention in setting loop. And when you are writing equation for mesh 1, then consider these polarity convention. That's why we have written inside the problem. So let's write it. It is V. Let's start from here. Plus, I am taking suppose engine quality. I1 is flying here, I1 R2. Plus, when it is passing from this, I just now told I1 minus I2 is the current flowing, because we are writing equation for mesh 1 multiplied with R1. Plus, I1 into R6 minus V1. Is equal to zero. Separate the value of I1 component, I2 component in this equation. So we get one. If we have assumed two variables, I1 and I2, so obviously then we need two equations to solve the value, to know the value of I1. Similarly, for mesh 2, write the equation. When you are writing for equation for mesh 2, consider while in the common branch, drop is I2 minus I1 into R1 with these polarity conditions written inside here. So what is the equation? It is plus of I2 R2